SpaceX has rescheduled its Falcon 9 rocket launch from Vandenberg Space Force Base for Sunday, marking the fourth delay for liftoff due to unfavorable weather conditions. And now, for a mysterious reason, the aerospace company announced Wednesday night. Welcome to First Class Tech, and in this video, we will see everything you need to know about the recent Starlink launch delay by SpaceX. Let's dive in. SpaceX has revealed a new and surprising reason for postponing its own rocket launch: constellation optimization. The mission, known as Starlink 2.4, is now scheduled to launch 51 Starlink V1.5 satellites into a semi-polar Earth orbit no later than 8:15 a.m. PST on Sunday, January 15th. This represents a significant shift in launch timing, as previous attempts aimed to lift off around 7 to 8 p.m. A significant time difference usually indicates that a launch is aiming for a completely different destination, but data provided by SpaceX suggests that this is not the case, raising more questions. Launch delays are nothing new for Starlink 2.4. Originally scheduled to launch in November of 2022, unspecified issues with the rocket forced SpaceX to postpone the mission indefinitely. NASA and an Israeli company launch then took precedence, pushing Starlink 2.4 into 2023. SpaceX set a January 9th target date, but that attempt was canceled due to bad weather in the Pacific Ocean, where the mission's Falcon 9 booster is scheduled to land. The mission was then postponed from January the 10th to January 11th to take a closer look at data from the second stage. SpaceX postponed the mission to January 14th to allow additional time for pre-launch checkouts. SpaceX delayed the mission again less than 4 hours later, settling on the current January 15th target date and introducing constellation optimization as a rare new cause of launch delays. Logical speculation suggested that the constellation optimization, in conjunction with a significant timing change, could have referred to a decision to launch Starlink 2.4 into a different orbital shell. The Starlink Gen 1 constellation from SpaceX has 5 distinct shells, and the company's Vandenberg Space Force Base, California launch pad, can theoretically launch to all of them. SpaceX's Starlink V1.5 satellites are also theoretically identical, which means that any satellite can launch to any shell and perform flawlessly. However, new orbit data released by SpaceX show that Falcon 9 will still launch Starlink 2.4 to a nearly identical orbit, and thus the same Group 2 shell as before. Constellation optimization could instead refer to changing which planes the same Group 2 satellites end up on, fine-tuning where and when their increased coverage will be felt most strongly by Starlink internet users. According to a trusted source, Starlink 2.4 will use Falcon 9 booster B1075, the second time the company has debuted a new Falcon booster on an internal mission. New Falcon boosters were almost always reserved for NASA or the US military, SpaceX's most conservative customers, until recently. However, SpaceX's Falcon booster reuse program has become so successful and routine that even NASA and the military appear hesitant to take advantage of the first launch of a new Falcon 9. B1075 will attempt to land on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You, approximately 662 kilometers southwest of California, off the Baja Peninsula of Mexico. It seems like you're enjoying our video. If you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you can get our future video updates. Now let's get back to the topic. The number of Falcon 9 launch shorts has steadily increased in recent months, presumably indicating that a single issue or adjustment is at least largely to blame. The streak started in early October 2022 and lasted until the end of November of 2022, resulting in 8 delays in 2 months, with effects ranging from minutes to days or even weeks. With the exception of one case, SpaceX's only explanation was a lack of time for data review, checkouts of the rocket, its payload, or both. SpaceX frequently discloses launch delays on Twitter, making it feasible to track when the corporation has indicated that it is standing down from a launch attempt or currently targeting a later launch date due to technical issues. SpaceX confirmed only three technical delays after publicly scheduling a launch between March of 2021 and October of 2022. To compound the strangeness, SpaceX reported at least 15 comparable delays between January of 2020 and March of 2021. The frequency of technical issues should reduce as a competent company gains expertise with the operation of a complicated new system. That appeared to be the pattern SpaceX was following, a significant decrease in the frequency of technical launch shorts, while the rate of Falcon 9 launches reached new heights. However, in the previous 3 months, the frequency of technical delays has increased from near zero to higher than at any other point in recent SpaceX history. It is tough to tell if there is an invisible link connecting the current spate of delays without context. Workforce tiredness, management changes, policy changes, and factory difficulties are all possible factors. It's even possible that the seeming rapid commencement was driven by an intentional shift in risk posture, such as boosting sensitivity to off-nominal signals that were previously seen but discounted enough to avoid launch delays. SpaceX may have modified things too much or cut too many steps as part of its ongoing drive to improve existing systems and processes. While doubtful, the current increase in delays could simply be a coincidence. Regardless, if the current pattern continues, it'll be tough for SpaceX to expand its launch cadence any further, especially in relation to Elon Musk's stated target of 100 launches in 2023. Delays can increase launch expenses and upset consumer schedules, driving a rapid return to smoother operations. Worryingly, a recent set of unconnected launches was postponed indefinitely. Starlink 2.4, which was originally slated to launch on November 18, has yet to acquire a new launch date after SpaceX allegedly detected difficulties following a Falcon 9 static fire test on November 17. After additional checks of the launch vehicle and data assessment, SpaceX postponed the second Falcon 9 launch, Japanese company iSpace's first moon landing attempt, indefinitely. Finally, launch delays are an inevitable aspect, and it is preferable to keep a rocket on the ground if there's any doubt about its readiness for flight. The Starlink internet is transforming in-flight connectivity, and the movement appears to be spearheaded by JSX, a public charter operator. According to recent company updates, half of JSX's fleet of Embraer regional jets are already equipped with Starlink in-flight internet. JSX expects to have the remainder of its fleet equipped with Starlink by the end of the second quarter. This would be quite a feat for JSX, as the airline only began installing Starlink systems on its jets in early December of 2022, following approval from the FAA. JSX will provide the service free of charge to its passengers, which is likely to be appreciated by the company's customers. Such a strategy would almost certainly pay off for the airline, especially since JSX intends to steadily grow its fleet by adding 1 to 2 aircraft per month to the foreseeable future. JSX currently operates 43 routes from 22 cities, including an international service to Cabo Lucas. Customers have been pleased with Starlink, according to JSX CEO Alex Wilcox. Our customers have been amazed and delighted by Starlink's in-flight Wi-Fi service. It is simply that good and so simple to use. As we continue to equip our fleet with this industry-leading product, which is provided completely free of charge to our customers, the gap between the JSX experience and the rest of the industry will widen, the CEO stated. Elon Musk has provided an update on the status of JSX's Starlink satellite internet. Musk wrote on Twitter, "Starlink in aircraft feels the same as a high-speed connection on the ground. Given the stability and speeds provided by Starlink, Musk's words may ring true." Some airlines have expressed interest in Starlink, including JSX and Hawaiian Airlines, which announced that the satellite internet solution would be added to some of its planes. However, according to previous reports, Starlink has yet to gain support from the United States' most prominent aircraft providers, such as Delta. Nonetheless, significant reductions in the frequency of delays are still notable, especially given that SpaceX normally does not discuss the cost of delays for non-NASA missions. If the mission is not delayed further, SpaceX will broadcast the launch and landing live beginning at 8:13 PST on Sunday. And with that being said, it is time to end our video. Before that, we would like to know, what expectations do you have from the upcoming Starlink launch? Let us know in the comments section below. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this one. We will see you in the next video.